Let's start with the tech, Keller. How is this generation different from those that we're familiar with from Zipline?
Well, you know, we've spent the last 7 years building this automated logistics network to a scale where today we serve enterprise and healthcare customers. We serve 3,400 hospitals and health facilities globally today. What we announced yesterday is exciting because so many of our customers, it's been clear that really the ultimate version of this technology is the ability to deliver directly to homes in a way that is 10 times faster, half the cost, and zero emission.
Right.
We've been using 3,000-pound gas combustion vehicles driven by humans to deliver things at scale of billions and billions of deliveries a year. That's really expensive. It's bad for the planet. There's a better way of doing that.
You have new commercial agreements for where this technology will be deployed. Who is going to be using it and where geographically?
Yesterday, we announced partnerships with the government of Rwanda, which has been one of our first customers, University of Michigan Medicine, and then also Sweetgreen. And over the coming months, we'll announce more and more partners for this sort of next generation technology platform across the U.S.
Keller, we're in the midst of a lot of breaking news now. First Republic Bank, Silicon Valley Bank. You're one of the most closely followed private startups out there. Can you just talk me through your exposure and how the last few days has been for you?
I think, we're certainly living in chaotic times. The good news is that, we bank with a diverse portfolio of banks, and Zipline's pretty darn well capitalized today. We're capitalized to fully scale this infrastructure across all the countries where we operate.
Hey, Keller, I know you're waiting on some pretty significant FAA approval. Just really quick, when are we going to see you guys break that next milestone, particularly here in the United States?
The good news is actually that the FAA has now enabled Zipline to turn on our detect and avoid system in the U.S. This is really the key technology that's required to fly beyond visual line of sight at scale. And so the good news is, although the FAA is being a little bit of a fast follower here to some of the other countries that already have this technology operating at national scale, the FAA is actually doing all the right things to make this service a reality for everybody who lives in the U.S.